Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marie, where I teach you different ways that you can make money online working from home. So this is a new video in my series on Upwork jobs for beginners. In today's video, I'm going to focus on teaching you how to become a video editor for social media and finding jobs like this on Upwork. I'm also going to do a demo video showing you how you can create your own short videos to use in your portfolio when you're applying to get these jobs. If you want more step-by-step instructions on how to apply to become a freelancer on Upwork, which is completely for free, I have linked you to my Upwork for Beginners playlist with many different tutorials on how to get started on Upwork as a freelancer. So let's get started. First of all, you're going to go to upwork.com, and after you've created your freelancing account, what we want to do is search for jobs. So at the top here, make sure that you click that you're searching for jobs. And we're going to type in video editing. And you can see that we have over 8,000 jobs that have popped up. Now, the type of jobs I'm focusing on today are video editing jobs for beginners that anyone can do, and you don't have to have a lot of experience. So what we want to do is click on experience level, entry, and intermediate. We also want to go down here and select under client info, payment verified. You can apply to jobs where it's not payment verified, but this way you know that this client is already payment verified and they're ready to hire someone. Now, if you want to apply for jobs where there haven't been so many proposals, so it's less competition, we can select these filters here, and that way we're not competing with over 50 people. So even with these filters, we have over 2,000 jobs that are available. So I want to narrow this down a bit. Let's put video editing TikTok, for example. You can see there's over 400 jobs available, and TikTok is great because most of these videos are less than 60 seconds long, and they're just looking for someone to quickly put together short videos with the footage that they already have. You can see all these different people. This person is looking for a long-term TikTok creator. They're willing to pay $150 for 10 videos, and these videos are between 10 and 45 seconds. I saw this one that was posted 3 hours ago. He's looking for a video editor that can handle short 60-second video edits. The edits are quick cuts, I think he wants to say, of public reactions. This guy's willing to pay $10 per video, and he has hundreds of videos for the right person. And if you go to the person's account, you can see that these are just really simple videos where they're just cutting together footage and adding text and maybe some sounds. It's nothing fancy. There's not motion graphics. It's really easy, basic stuff. Okay, so when you're ready to apply for one of these jobs, you're just going to click here, submit a proposal. Now you have an option to propose with a specialized profile or your general profile. So if you've created a video editing profile, you can do that here. It says, how do you want to be paid? By milestone, by project? Let's put by project. The guy's budget is $10, so we're going to keep that as 10 per video. Of course, Upwork does take a commission, so you would receive $8 per video. You could negotiate this, but when you're starting out, I recommend meeting the person at their budget and not trying to bid higher than the actual job, because you do want to build your portfolio. Here, how long will the project take? We want to put less than 1 month, and then you're going to put your cover letter. Okay, so for example, it could be something as simple as this. Hello, I am very interested in becoming your video editor for your TikTok series. I reviewed the videos on your Battle Bunker channel. Now, if you know the person's name or their channel, I recommend putting it in there, and that way they know this is not just a copy-paste cover letter. And I'd be able to recreate that same style with my video editing skills. I have over years of experience video editing and have worked with many clients on similar projects for their YouTube channels, TikTok, Instagram, and Facebook accounts. Now, if you don't have any experience video editing, don't put this in there. Just skip to this next part and saying, I have attached a few links to my work below. So don't apply to a job like this without samples. You need to show samples of your work. So if you don't have any samples because you have never worked with clients before, that's okay. When I started working as a voiceover artist, I didn't have any voiceover jobs, so I created my own demo reel and I created my own samples of my work that I then sent to these people. And once they liked it, they hired me. And later on, I built a natural portfolio. But until then, you can practice your video editing skills and send them samples of videos you have created for yourself, for your portfolio. So you can drag or upload project files. You could upload an actual video, but I find that people prefer a link. They don't want to download and, you know, fill up their computer with videos. So they prefer a link to a YouTube video or something that you can show them somewhere where they can just click quickly and watch it without having to actually download it. So then I would recommend you insert links, a couple links to your different videos that you have created, and then say, I am looking forward to discussing your project further with you. Warm regards, Jennifer, or whatever your name is. And here you have the option to boost your proposal, or you can just leave this to not waste your connects and then click send for two connects. Another thing you're going to want to do is at the top here, click on profile and make sure that at the bottom here, you have things filled out in your portfolio. So you're going to want to add some little demo videos that you've created here. So now what I'm going to do is teach you how to create your own video. So for this type of job, most of these videos are in the portrait style. So I'm going to show you how to create a video like this with Filmora. Now, Filmora is one of the most affordable video editing softwares out there. I use it for most of my video editing. You can also use a free option like VSDC, but in this video, I'm going to show you how to do this with Filmora. You can purchase Filmora by clicking in the link in the description below and use my referral link, and also have a free trial to see if you like it. But it really is the easiest video editing software, in my opinion, and it's especially great for doing little videos like this for TikTok or for Instagram or YouTube. So first of all, when you're trying to create your own demo videos, you need footage. So decide what kind of video you want to make, and then you can go to pixabay.com/videos or click here on videos. And you can type in, well, let's say in this example, we're making a video, a little fitness related video, fitness. And all of these videos below here are free to use, royalty free to use in your projects. So download a few of these, and to download one of these videos, just click. Then you're going to click here on free download and choose the size and then download. And it will download to your computer. Now all of these videos are in the landscape size, but I'm going to show you how to edit them into portrait size, which is what is used in TikTok and Instagram Reels and Facebook Reels and YouTube Shorts. So you can download a few different videos, and then you can also go to Pixabay and click on music and search for any type of music that you want to use. So there are all sorts of different amazing music tracks that you can use for free as well, and you don't have to pay anything to use these. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is go to File, New Project, and make sure you click 9 to 16 portrait. That will give us that portrait style that we want for these TikTok videos. Here you're going to import your media. So just click to import your media and then click open. And this is our song that we're going to use, our three media clips, and then a little logo at the end. Now, the first thing I like to do is add the music because we like to adjust the videos or photos with the music to sync it with the beat. So we're going to click on the music track and drag it down here to where it has the audio, because this is the music track. Now to press play, you can press the space bar or just play. So now we're going to add our first clip. So we're going to click on this one here and drag it down to the video track. It might ask you this. You can just click keep project settings. So as you can see here, the video only covers this portion and we want it to cover the entire thing. So what we're going to do is drag it and drag on these nodes and adjust it so that it fills the entire screen, and you can just drag it wherever you want it. I want it to be kind of like that in the center, and then you can press play to preview. Okay, so this here is the timeline, and you can click on this zoom out button to see all of the different clips, or zoom in, and this makes it easier when you're trying to edit. I'm only going to use about 30 seconds of the audio. So what I want to do is drag this playhead here to around 35 seconds, click on the audio track and then click here on this icon to split it. So we've just split the audio into two. Then I want to delete this by clicking on it and just hitting the delete key on the keyboard. So let's say I only want to use a few seconds of this footage. I can split it where I want it. Let's say I want it to start here. I'm going to click on the track, click to split, or you can press Control plus B to split. And that's just split out this section here. So I'm going to click on that section, click the delete key. And let's say I want it to go to around here, and then I'm going to press the split again. And then I want to split it again here, and I'm going to erase this part by clicking and then delete. So now I want to show you how we can add a cool effect to this. We're going to go up here to effects, click on that. And there's so many different effects you can use. If you go to the side here and click free, this will show you all the free ones that are included without having to get an extra plan. The first one I want to use, I'm going to click here, is RGB and press enter. And we have this RGB stroke one, which is cool. So you have two different options. You can click and drag it over the entire clip, and that will give you the effect during the entire clip. But what I like to do, I'm going to go edit, undo, is drag it and put it on the top, and that way you can adjust for how long you want this effect to appear. So I don't want this effect to appear through the entire clip, just through part of it. So you can click and adjust the length, if you see these arrows here, to adjust it so you can control how long it's going to pop up for. Now for the second part, I want to show you how you can speed up or slow down a clip. So let's say I want to speed this up. I'm going to right click, go to uniform speed. You can adjust it up to make it faster or down to make it slower. So I'm going to put this at around 4 and then okay. Now let's go back to media and we'll add our second clip. Again, we'll click and drag to add it to the timeline. And we'll do the same thing as we did before. Just click on the nodes and we'll zoom up so it fills the entire portrait video. Okay, so let's say I want to split it around here. I'm going to click split and then delete. Now, if you want to make any edits to the color, you can double click on it and click on color. And you can click on auto to auto adjust the color or adjust the temperature or the tone, or you can just leave it as it is. Make this a little bit brighter and then click okay. Let's say I want to add another effect here. I'm going to go back to effects and this time type in chromatic. And I want to use this chromatic aberration one for a small portion of the clip. Okay, now let's add our final video. Again, click and drag, and then just adjust the nodes so it fills the frame. Click to split and then delete. Now, if any of these have audio that you want to remove, you can see here, there's audio on this clip here, and I just want to use the audio that I've added. So I'm going to click on the clip with audio, then right click, and you can adjust, click on adjust audio or just mute. So I've just clicked mute and now we're not going to have any audio in that video file. Okay, so I want to add one more effect to this video. Back to effects, I'm going to type in colorful and use this colorful flicker one. Just drag it where I want to add it. And the last thing I want to do is add a little logo at the end. So let's say this is the logo of the company or whatever. I'm going to make it small. And then I want to add a little animation. So I'm going to double click on it, click on animation, and you've got these preset animations or preset motions. I'm going to use this vortex in one. I think that's kind of cool. Okay, so now what I want to do is add some cool transitions between these two clips. I'm going to click on transitions And there's all sorts of different ones. Again, if you click here on free, you'll see all the different free transitions that you can use, or click on the side here and use any of these. First one I want to use is this wormhole 6. So to add the transition, I'm going to click and drag it between these two clips. And the second one I want to use is wormhole 3 and drag it between these two clips. Okay, so now I want to show you how to add some titles or text. So you're going to click here on titles. Again, search for the free ones. And I want to go to basic. Now you can use any of these. There's word art ones. There's lots of really cool ones that you can use, but I want to show you how you can create your own. So we're going to click on basic. Just click on basic 4 and click and drag it to the very top. You want it to be at the top, the titles, because that's the top layer. So if we double click on the text, we can go here to font and we can type in our title. So I'm going to put in this summer, dot, dot, dot. You can click and drag it wherever you want to add it. And then you can adjust the font type. So I'm going to highlight it and then use whichever one you like. Let's say I want this one here. You can click and use any of these text styles or click on advanced and add a shadow if you want as well and choose the color of the shadow. We can even add an animation. And then you can choose save as custom to use this again and again. So let's put fitness title 1. Okay. And then okay. We can click and drag where we want it to pop up. And you'll see if we go play. And then if you go here under custom, you'll have your fitness title 1 here, and we can use that again and again. And then just add as many titles as you want and click and drag to position them. You can make them shorter by clicking and shortening it as well. Okay, and the last thing I want to show you is how to fade out the audio so that it doesn't just cut off. If we press play, you hear the audio just cuts off. We want that to fade out. So if you go to the audio, you see this little marker here. You can click and drag and it will fade out, and you can make it a short fade or a long fade depending on what you like. So let's try that. Good. Okay, so when you're done your video, we're going to export it. So to do that, we'll click export, create video, and just click on local, MP4, put in your title, and then just keep the preset as it is, and then just click export. So now it's going to export our video. Okay, and when it's finished, you can click open folder, and we can watch our video. So what you can do is add this video to your portfolio on Upwork and create a few different videos like this with different styles using different effects and upload those to Upwork and also upload them to YouTube so you can generate a link that you can send to your clients when you are applying to these types of jobs. Okay, so I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial on how to become a video editor and apply to jobs on Upwork. If you have any other questions about video editing, make sure to ask me in the comment section below. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in my next tutorial.